Oh, you better not go in there. Yeah, good decision. Hi everybody, this is Ray at the Practice 55712 channel. I'm on the north side of my house today, and it's been raining for about 3 days straight. 10% chance of rain every day is what the weather said, and every single day we have had a tremendous thunderstorm. So thank you, Mr. Weatherman. I appreciate your efforts. But the nice thing about it is the extra rain on the north side of my house has brought out something really kind of nice, and the smell is fantastic. I'm going to zoom in really close and show you what's been making everything smell really nice around my house. These little flowers are called Lily of the Valley, or Lilies of the Valley. I don't know, some darn kind of the valley. But I have so many of these. It's about 3 feet thick from the outside to the house, and then all along the north side of my house. Whoever used to live here really did like these things and planted quite a few of them, but the smell on these is absolutely beautiful. Take a look at these. Neat, huh? Little bells. But they do have a fantastic smell. They tend to spread a lot. I have to keep mowing up against them to keep them from taking over my yard. So I guess that's a good thing. I don't have to worry about upkeep on these. Kind of nice. And the smell when the sun comes out and it warms up and it's not quite so wet out here, the smell is phenomenal. Today I'm going to start out with red onions, also known as Bermuda onions. I used to call them Bermuda onions, but they don't call them that anymore. They call them red onions. But I'm going to plant onion sets in this bed. It's not a very big bed, but then again, I don't need a whole heck of a lot of onions. And I figured, well, since I'm coming out here, might as well bring the camera, because I told you I would be showing you how I plant everything in the garden this year, and I'm going to keep up with that. So to start out, let's do some onions. So like I said, we're going to start out with onions. They come in a bag generally, and they're called onion sets. And what an onion set is, you plant a seed, and the first season it generally grows a small onion, and that's harvested. That's called an onion set. You save that, and then the next season you plant that, and then it grows even bigger and then forms a full-size bulb, and then that would be a full-size onion, because onions take quite a long time to mature. So generally, you're going to start out with onion sets, because you don't have the time to plant a seed and wait for it to go all the way to a bulb. That only works for green onions, you know, the tall green onions that you eat. These are the bulb onions, the kind that you see in the grocery store, the big red ones. I love these because they have a great flavor. So let's do the onions. As far as getting the garden soil ready, your guess is as good as mine. It's been raining for 3 days straight. 10% chance of rain each day according to the weatherman, and we've had a downpour with thunder and lightning every single day, and I could whine and gripe and moan about it and lose my mind, but what would that serve? So I might as well keep a positive state of mind and think, well, at least I don't have to water these when I'm done. When I was making these beds last season, I got a lot of questions on why these beds are only 1 foot wide by 4 foot long. Why not make them bigger? Well, I made them according to the size of what I'm going to be planting in here. For instance, onions. They don't take a lot of space in here just for the bulb, and so why would I need a wider bed? I can get by just fine with this. It's less weed control, because when it's not very wide, you don't have to worry about weeds getting in here. It suits me. Whatever size you want to do, knock yourself out. 1 foot by 4 foot, that's all I needed, so that's all I made. I have a ton of bulbs in here. There are like endless amounts. And I got them for $1.98. That's a pretty good deal. And I'm going to plant these one on each side and then go forward. Oops, let's get one that's already sprouted. Not right in the middle, but just a little bit forward like that. 6 inches, 6 inches, and then I'm going to do the same over here. That way it gives the bulb room to form, and they're not quite touching, so I get the maximum use of my space. If I did them like this, they would bump up against each other. So I'm kind of staggering them like that. And I always look for the bulbs that already have the most growth. I start with those first and then end with the least growing ones, because I figure, what the heck, I might as well plant the best bulbs I have. I'm probably not going to be able to plant all of these here, but I'll find space somewhere throughout the garden to toss them here and there to make sure I get them all planted, because you can never have too many onions. So I push them down like that and cover them up with soil. Just barely cover them up. I know, that is so darn difficult, isn't it? Good thing you have me here to show you. Okay, let's see. Right there, I got to do some more. These things are just as impatient as I am. They were outgrowing their pot, getting a little top heavy, and I was trying to hold off on clipping them back because I wanted to get them out in the garden, but with all the rain, I decided to wait. And then I decided, yeah, what the heck, I'm gonna put them in the garden anyway. So these two are my peppercinis, and I'm gonna plant those in a 1-foot by 4-foot bed, but I'm only gonna take up half the bed. I'm gonna place one right over here, and then one about maybe 1.5 feet away, and that should be just fine. They're gonna grow together a little bit, but a little bit of crowding with peppers doesn't matter as long as their roots have plenty of room to grow. So if you're cut for space and you wanna make sure that you get the maximum use out of your garden, just remember, give your peppers around 1 foot on either side of the main stem for roots, and you're gonna be just fine. Where it goes after that is totally okay, because it's not really gonna go like hog wild and kill the other plant. As long as it has enough roots, they will grow together, they'll be just fine. You can grow them 2 to 3 feet apart if you wanna make sure that you have like this big, bushy, get out of my, hey, Rascal. No. He's standing in there with 1 foot inside a raised bed looking back at me like that. Rascal, you can't be doing that. Okay, I'm trying to be serious here. Anyway, I like to plant them about maybe 1 to 1.5 feet apart. You can plant them around 3 feet apart if you want a perfectly rounded, beautiful specimen of a plant, but I don't go for specimens. I just go for production and fun. So I wanna plant these about maybe 1.5 feet apart. It'll give me a little bit more room over here in case I have something else that I wanna plant. And with me, I never know from day to day if I'm gonna get something different. So I have a little bit of open space right here. I'm gonna get these in the ground. Peanut shells. There's everything in my garden. I don't know where a peanut shell came from. But anyway, let's see what the soil looks like. Ooh, a couple ants in here. That's not bad. Sometimes ants are bad for your garden. Sometimes they're good. Ooh, a worm. That's a good sign. All kinds of stuff. Every day's like Easter here. I find all kinds of stuff in my soil. It's weird. I've always been like that ever since I was a kid. I love digging in the dirt. So I guess gardening is a natural thing for me because I just love digging around, seeing what I can find. Now these are first year raised beds. I don't have a ton of soil all the way up to the top because each year I'm gonna add compost. Ooh, look at this. This is a natural earthworm. This was not put in here. This was in my garden. Say hello to YouTube. He is gonna have such a good time in here. I'm so glad I saw him and didn't chop him in half. Okay, I'm down to the cardboard. So I'm gonna stop right there. Take out the tag. Oh, you know, I forgot to put the tags over by the melons. So I don't have any idea which one is the Hokkaido melon and which one is the Charleston gray. I guess we're gonna find out when they grow up, won't we? All right, taking it out of the pot. I place my hand right here, upside down. Beat the heck out of it. And we're all set to go, and ooh, there's the worm. I'm gonna put this right down on top of you, Mr. Worm. Worm, meet my plant. Plant, ooh, there's another one. Must be his girlfriend. Put Mrs. Worm down there. Be fruitful and multiply. Have all kinds of little baby worms. We won't discuss that because that would be sexual education and that's not what my channel is about. All right, you guys have a good time down there. And make nice and poop a lot. I planted this just a little bit deeper than the original soil line. Sometimes I'll plant my pepper plants extra deep to make sure that they get extra roots on the stems, but this time I planted it just a little bit deeper because I really don't want to go into the original soil, and I wanted to show you how I plant these. This is fine for now, and they're going to do just fine with production, with spreading out. Definitely keep you updated. So much for wondering what I was going to plant in this space. I just remembered I have a tomatillo that I planted, I don't know, when did I plant you? In March. And it's gotten really big and a really strong stem, thicker than my little finger. It got a little bit too tall for this, so I cut it back. It's got all kinds of new growth, but I want to grow a tomatillo outside because I've never done it. And now I have the space, full sun. You saw how big the tomatillo got inside. I'm dying to find out how big it's going to get here. You may be wondering, is it going to take over here? Probably not, because I'm going to keep this pruned to be a nice shape and to not interfere with my pepper plants, because this is just for fun and this is for pickled peppers later on in the year, which I'll be showing you. But I want to plant this right here because I really have no other place to grow it. Right here is where it's going to go.